Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for taking the time to join us today. My name is Ryan Berry, and I work for Buckinghamshire University in the UK. So today I'm going to be giving you an oversight on all things at Buckinghamshire University, and I'm also a graduate of the university as well. So if there are any questions about the student experience as well, I'll be more than happy to talk to you about some of my experiences as well. So, just some general information about the university. You can see here this large blue building, that is our gateway building. So that is home to an on-site sports hall, a gym, a five-story library that's open 24 hours a day. And we also have film studios and music studios within that as well. But you can see on the right that we are a relatively small university. We only have around 8,000 students. That might seem like a lot, but there are other universities that have over 50,000 students. So we're quite small, which means we've got excellent, flexible, personal relationships between our lecturers and our students because of the smaller class sizes. And we're located in Buckinghamshire. And where we are right next to London. So although we aren't part of the City of London, we have trains that run there, several trains run there an hour, and you can get there within 30 minutes. So you get the benefit of living in a nice English town, but you've got the country's capital right next door as well. Just a little map here, just to reiterate where we are. We're actually pretty much equal between London and Oxford as well, and just some lovely pictures of countryside there. Sadly, our weather isn't always as nice as it is in these pictures, but it does happen some days of the year. Okay, so I'll now show you a small video that features some of our students talking to you about why they chose Bucks and what they like about the university.
My first impression of the university was how modern and vibrant it was.
So on the first day I arrived, I was very nervous. Not as big as many universities, but that small community definitely helped. So everyone knew each other, very close-knit.
When I first came to the university, you see the nice big blue building. Campus can be a very inspiring place because when you come in, especially into the studio, it's nice and bright. It just sort of works for me.
I chose to study performing arts here at Bucks because of the diversity and range of modules within the course, from directing to presenting. There was just so much to actually do on the course as a whole.
So my favourite facilities here are probably number one being the gym, probably Bisham Abbey. So the place we go and train and play hockey. It's a great facility. Going there Wednesday afternoon with all the boys is great fun.
Having a range of facilities is really important. So we have different woodworking shops, metal workshops, ceramics workshops.
The course lets us use a variety of facilities.
It's just convenient to be next to somewhere like London that has like all these references for all these different subjects areas, whether it be in design or in sport. So there's a lot of things to get involved in, a lot of work experience to take, a lot of things to be put on your CV from being here. Outside of uni, I tend to do a lot of like photography and videography. I mainly focus on like time-lapse and hyperlapse photography and tend to look for vantage points around the area, like West Wickham Hill.
So my hopes for the future are to be with a sports team as a sports therapist. Now I'm feeling ready for my career. The university gives you great background, especially the degree. So from that, I've got lots of confidence to go into the career.
I think I've got a good amount of skills and knowledge now to be able to go out there and get the job that I want.
So those are all students of the university studying a range of different courses, but everything within that video was filmed either on the campus or around the local town. And I'd just like to reiterate again what they said about the sense of community. Because we have smaller class sizes, you may only be in a class of perhaps 10 to 15 people. It means that you get to know everybody else really quickly, and the lecturers get to know you really quickly as well. So just some more information here. We've had 100 million invested into our campuses to make sure that all of our facilities are the same standard as any facilities being used today. And you can see here from some of these pictures the kind of facilities that we have. So in the bottom right picture, you'll see one of our students in a plane, because we have a range of aviation courses. We have students playing with virtual reality technology. We have some students in our libraries and in our creative studios as well. And it's worth saying, if you have any hobbies at the university, every classroom is open to every student. So as long as you know how to use that space and there's not a class going on in there, you can book it out and have access to it as well. And we also have the top three students' union in the UK. So a students' union is a separate organization within the university that focuses on the extracurricular activities. So one of the students in that video talked about playing hockey. So if you are interested in any sports, if you have any other hobbies, chances are we have a society that runs that, and they're all free to join for our students as well. And if you have a hobby that is not featured at the university, if you find 10 other people that are also interested, you can receive some funding to do that as well. And it's something else you can do alongside your degree. So we've been awarded the Silver Award in the Teaching Excellence Framework, which is recognized for our supportive learning and community again. And something you'll see in a lot of these pictures, you won't see any students just staring at a board. It is all about working together, creating physical projects that you can take away with you. So here we've got students doing group work in all of these pictures. You'll also see some of the more sport facilities in the top right image. And again, working in the computer suites as well, and working on big group projects together. It's all about practical work, practical knowledge. It isn't just about taking down notes on what you're being told. It's very much about what you take away from the information that you're being given and what you want your focus within that subject to be. If you come to our university and you know exactly what you want to do, the lecturers will support you to strengthen your skills within that area to secure your dream job. So although you might be set the same assessment as your classmates, the work that you submit is very much down to you, and the lecturers love it when students do that as well. So just some general achievements around the university that we're very proud of. So we're voted top 30 in the UK. That's a survey run by students that voted for this. Our fashion degree programmes are best in London and the South East. We are 37th for graduate salaries in the UK as well. Again, because of our practical courses, we really set our students up for employment and future work, either within their dream field or maybe even their exact dream job. Just some work about our carbon footprint and emissions. We actually set ourselves a target to achieve by 2022, but we are well ahead of that target. We very much care about the environment and the community, and indeed the planet as well. You see here we have electric vehicles on site. We've given over 11,000 hours into volunteering, and that's something that our students run. It might be something that you join to volunteer within, or it might be something that you do yourself that you care a lot about. Again, the university will support you with any additional volunteering work, community work that you want to do. So we have world leading and internationally excellent research in a range of different disciplines. Again, in all of these pictures, you'll see students working together in a variety of different fields, whether it is in nursing or business, sport, aviation, the arts, volunteering, whatever it might be. We make sure that the information we give to you is what is being practiced today. And in fact, our facilities are so advanced and so relevant to what is happening in the world today that even our nursing students, the facilities they operate in, can also become a hospital, should it need to be. It can be a fully functioning hospital ward, should that ever need to be used. I'm preparing you for the world of work. So I've mentioned this before, but all of our courses are career focused. They have been designed specifically based on what is happening in the field today. Quite a common story amongst our graduates is once they take on their first job after university, they quickly climb the ranks of that business, becoming a manager, a project leader, whatever it might be, because what we have taught them at the university exceeds what other employees at this business are currently doing. So the knowledge we give you is, in some cases, even more advanced than what people who work in that field already know. We also have industry relevant opportunities on offer as well. So whether that's some form of part-time placement, perhaps, whether it's some kind of summer work, or even with a lot of our business courses, you will have guest lecturers come in and they will give you a brief that you need to fill. And in a lot of cases, when you present your idea to this business, you won't do it in a classroom. You'll do it at that business's head office, whether that might be in London or further north in England in somewhere like Manchester. We will take you there and you will deliver this in a professional setting. And quite often as well, students will be offered jobs after these briefs, because again, when the lecturers get to know you so well, all of our lecturers are from this field of work and they still have connections within that industry. And when they see what your specific skills are, they know instantly what kind of business, what kind of person you would do well to work with or work for. Here are some example companies that our students have gone onto. This isn't all of them. The list itself is pages and pages, but I'm sure you recognize some of these here. Universal Studios, Film Studio, Virgin Atlantic, British Airways. There's also police, Microsoft, the BBC, different fashion industries, National Health Service, England. There's a wide array of places that you can go into. And just because you study, for example, business, it doesn't mean that you won't then perhaps find a job working for a fashion studio, because it isn't just about the design, it's also about how to operate as a business. Just because you study business doesn't mean you can't go into the aviation field, for example. The courses that you will study with us offer you such a wide array of opportunities, and you won't just walk away with one area of knowledge. Everything you learn will just be so vast that the opportunities for you are just a huge, huge list that is available to you. Just some information about our accommodation. So it is guaranteed for all of our first year students. We actually have three different sites, all of which are very close to the university. The furthest accommodation is only a 10 to 15 minute walk away. That's where I lived when I was a student. It's this image in the top left corner. And I consider myself quite a lazy person, but I still manage to walk in every single day. So if I can do that, you guys can too. But typically you'll be sharing with perhaps five other people. And some of our facilities are a shared bathroom and shared kitchen with your own bedroom. Other sites are your own bedroom, your own bathroom, and then a shared kitchen. But we also have studio facilities available as well. It's completely your own space. So in this top left image, that is one of our studios. So you can see that she has her desk, study area. You can see the corner of her bed, and behind where the picture was taken is her kitchen and bathroom. And there's also a balcony there, which is lovely. So we've got a lot of different options available, and whatever you choose, it is guaranteed for your first year with us. So I've spoken some about the Students' Union, but now I'm going to let the Students' Union team tell you a little bit more about themselves and what the Students' Union does for our students.
I'm Teo, and I'm president of Buck Students' Union.
Christina, vice president, student involvement.
Brooke, vice president, education and welfare.
And we are your sabbatical officers, the first ever all-female team.
elected by you
to dynamically lead your union,
tenaciously represent you,
inspire you,
and above all, make life better for students at Buck. As a student of Buckinghamshire New University, you are automatically a member of Buck Students' Union, one of the top three students' unions in the UK. We are a not-for-profit charity, which means for every pound spent in the bar, 36p is reinvested into the union to provide some truly diverse opportunities.
Over 30 different sports teams where you can competitively represent the university in local and national leagues.
The power to select and fundraise for local charities with full union support. An advice centre, giving you impartial and confidential guidance on matters affecting you.
Over 22 different societies, ranging from musical theatre to gaming, and will even give you the support and guidance to create your very own.
From club nights to quiz nights, comedy nights to live music nights, and our massive annual festival, our award-winning venue has it all. Give back to the community through volunteering projects.
The chance to take part in sport recreationally through our Sport for Fun programme.
Additional skills training sessions to enhance your CV and boost your employability. The opportunity to represent and voice the opinions of your social or academic pay group.
Thanks to the big deal, everything run by Buck Students' Union is completely free. The only union in the UK to offer this package.
Giving you the opportunity to try new things, meet new people and gain career-enhancing skills to last a lifetime. Hundreds of different recreational activities giving you the chance to try and experience new things.
Every time you participate in an activity with us, be it volunteering, a skill session or securing a committee role, we have record of it and are now able to collate these records to really showcase your involvement through the Bucks Award.
We're here for you no matter how you study, whether you're based at a partner college, study part-time, international, mature or postgraduate student, we'll help support and guide you along your journey.
We're also here to make the changes that you want. Union Council is a great way to suggest new ideas and to help improve the students' union and university, meeting every month and open to all of our members.
You can even follow in our footsteps to be part of our annual elections to become a sabbatical officer, an NUS delegate, a student trustee or executive officer to help lead one of the top student unions in the UK. We'll support you to campaign on bigger issues, from mental health awareness to campus safety and the future of your education.
So whether you're giving back to the community, competing in a sports team, improving your employability, or simply having a good time,
we're your students' union and we're waiting for you to join in.
Okay, you would have seen there as well, jamesbinghamfilms.com. That was actually made by one of our graduates who studied the film course. So we are also always very excited to be working with our graduates as well on projects that can help the university. And something you would have seen and heard through that video as well, it's not just about the fun, although it is really, really fun to do these things. All of these can go towards boosting your employability and your CV and resume as well. Within all of these different societies and sports that you saw, they are led by students. Students have roles within those societies. So you won't just be playing football or rugby. You may be the president of that society who is in charge of all the organization and the decisions. You may be the treasurer who is in charge of all of the financing for that society and any funds that you may need to do the things that your society wants to do. But as a student, all of it is free to you. And this all goes towards just giving you further experiences and different things that you can strive for and achieve whilst you're a student. It isn't just about learning whatever course it is you may have applied for. It's the full package. This place, whatever university you choose to go to, it's going to be your home for the next 3 years. So you want to make sure that place has everything that you could possibly want it to have, not just on your course, but on every aspect of your life for those 3 years as well. And again, just some other things that we have our own radio station, a student newspaper, a union council, again, a lot of different fundraising exercises as well. And that students' union team talking throughout that video, they were all former students as well. So if that's something that may appeal to you, once you've graduated with us, you can then run a campaign to become the president. And who the president is decided by the current students. And again, all of these things just go towards helping your employability prospects. So that is the end of the presentation. Thank you all so much for listening. I hope you enjoyed everything that was in there. I'm sure that you will possibly have some questions now, and I'm happy to answer any that I can. And you'll see my personal email address is on the screen as well. So if there's anything you want to talk to me about, by all means, get in touch day or night. I do not mind. And if I don't know the answer, I will certainly find the answer for you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ryan. So the first question that we have is from Pratik Patak. When do we get CAS once we have a unconditional offer letter from Box?
Sure, that is a very good question. Actually, right now, with the COVID-19 situation developing, we are committed to welcoming our students in September, but we are having to follow government guidance on policies like this as well. So if you have an unconditional offer, your CAS will be incoming. We're just having to wait for further guidance first around the COVID-19 situation. But if you are someone that's in that position, you have an unconditional offer, but you don't yet have your CAS, further information and updates will be sent out to you, and it will only be a matter of time.
Thank you, Ryan. So the next question is from Shruti Malik. Would you plan to have an MBA replacement?
An MBA replacement?
Yes, that's the question.
Okay, so we do actually have a few different MBA options available. So we have a full-time on-campus MBA, we have an international MBA, and we also have part-time and online MBAs as well. So you can study an MBA with us from your own home. I'm sorry, I hope that answers your question. I'm sorry if that doesn't.
Okay, thank you. So the next question we have is, do you consider MOI letter for English requirement papers?
If that's the situation that you're in, I would recommend, if you already have that, by all means, please send it over to me and we can review it and get back to you directly. That's absolutely fine.
Thank you. Moving on to the next question from Shajid Merchant, what is cost of studying a course at Bucks per year? Are there scholarships for international students?
Yes, very good question. So the typical cost of our courses for 1 year is, on average, it's £12,500. 90% of our courses cost £12,500. At the moment, regarding scholarships, we're actually reviewing all of our scholarship offerings at the moment. Unfortunately, I can't say too much right now. The ones that I have seen that may go ahead are very exciting, so it's annoying that I can't say too much about them. But as soon as they become live, we will be announcing that out to everybody, and we'll be taking you through all of the information to apply for any scholarships as well.
Thank you. So the next question is quite similar, from Prashant Mukundauni, who's asking, please say more about scholarship programs. So we already had this question.
Yeah, I did answer that, but I promise we will be sending all of that information out as soon as we have it. And it would be, what I will say as well, to anybody wondering about scholarships, if you are interested, in Bucks, absolutely submit your application. And as soon as you have the unconditional offer, you can then still apply for a scholarship. So if you would rather wait and see, that's absolutely fine. But if you want to come to us, do submit your application. And then when scholarships are live, they will be passed out to you.
Sounds great. Thanks, Ryan. So the next question is from Sajid, asking, which are the top courses offered by Bucks?
Oh, the top courses. That's a good question. As I work for Bucks, I would have to say all of our courses are the top courses. But really, it depends on what you are most interested in, whatever field that might be. Like I said earlier, if you have a particular interest or you know exactly what your dream job might be, that's what you should make your decision based on. And as well, any interest that you have, you can incorporate those into your course. So this may be a bit of a non-answer, but our top course will be whatever one you apply for and get out of it. I hope that's an okay answer.
Thanks, Ryan. Shajid is also asking another question. Is £12,500, so does £12,500 include room and board or only tuition?
No, so it doesn't include living costs. It's only the cost of the course. You will see on our accommodation pages on our website. By the way, our website is just the end of my email address, bucks.ac.uk. On there, you'll find all of our information. Yovana, I'm so sorry. Can you repeat the question, please?
So basically, does £12,500 include the room?
Yes, thank you. No, so your living costs are separate, but all of our accommodation costs are online, so you can see those as well, and you can calculate it from there. Typically, for the year, the average you'll need is around £9,000. That's for your living costs, and that covers everything outside of your course. So that is your rent, your food, perhaps any travel and entertainment as well. And I will say on that note as well, there are so many job opportunities around our university as well. Our campus is right next door to a huge shopping centre that has over 150 stores inside it. And all of those employ our students on a part-time basis as well. And they are very understanding of your student timetable. So if you are concerned with being able to fund yourselves, part-time work is absolutely available to you as well.
That's really useful. Thank you, Ryan. The next question is a bit specific from Pratik. I have an unconditional offer for MSc Aviation Regulations from Bucks in September 2020 session. Are we still running the session since COVID-19 restrictions are still in place?
Yes. Firstly, congratulations on your offer. That's really exciting. So at the moment, we are committed to welcoming students in September. If for any reason we can't welcome students in September, you will be able to begin your course online. And then as soon as you can arrive, you will be able to arrive, and we'll make arrangements for that so that it definitely works for you. At the moment, the anticipation is you will arrive in September and there will still be social distance measures in place. So some of your courses may be taught online, but then other modules and classes will be on campus for, but you'll be in slightly smaller groups just with all the necessary steps with the COVID situation. As that develops as well, we will be keeping all of our students up to date, but right now we are sincerely planning to be seeing you in September.
Thank you. And the critique also has a question: how are travel and visa scheduling affected with the COVID situation?
Sure, yeah, no, that is a very good question. So at the moment, everything is slightly delayed, unfortunately, like I mentioned with the CAS slightly earlier on. So at the moment, we can't issue a CAS until we know the official government policy. But as things develop, again, I'm saying this so much, I'm sorry, but we will be contacting everybody with information that they need to know. And in terms of travel arrangements as well, with regards to booking flights over and things like that, I would recommend, just for your own well-being, to not yet book flights. Hold off on doing that for as long as you're able to, just in case of any flight cancellations, because it's not just, we're not the only people within that question. And there's also airlines and whatever their policies might be as well. So hold off on booking flights just for as long as you're comfortable doing. and then we will get you here just as soon as we are able to.
Thank you, Ryan. The next question is a bit specific one. So I think for detailed information, the student can email you directly, but we can cover it quickly. Is there pharmaceutical science available at Bucks?
Oh, what course was that, sorry?
Pharmaceutical science.
Oh, yes, we are. Okay, so yeah, please do email me about that. We are. That course has been discussed or something similar to that. So if you can, please just email me, ryan.berry@bucks.ac.uk, and I'll get back to you with the specifics that are available to you.
Thank you, Ryan. Another question from Maud Umar. Can engineering students also apply for MBA?
Yes, absolutely. With our MBA, it is not particularly specific in terms of what your academic or professional history might be. If you have some experience within business, that is certainly preferable. But in your case, if you're coming strictly from an engineering background, it would depend entirely on the strength of your application. So within your application, in your statement of intent, you would just need to talk about why you feel an MBA is right for you and why you are right for the MBA with your engineering history. I'm more than happy to help you with that as well if you would like to email me with any questions. And that advice goes out to everybody as well. Just because you studied something doesn't mean you can't then go on to study something else. It just very much depends on your application and you being able to explain why you want this career change.
Thank you, Ryan. We have another very specific question from Rajni Saini. What are the credit exemption details for the accounting studies?
Oh, that one I would definitely say please email me about, because I'll have to ask some of my other colleagues. So yeah, please send me that in an email and with any kind of specific information that you need, and I'll get the answers for you.
Thank you, Brian. Another question is from Depti. Are there any MSc computer science or related courses at Bucks University? I could find only cyber security. Also, kindly let me know if there is MSc computer science or related with placement option.
Sure. So at the moment, cyber security, MSc cyber security would be the closest that we have for that. But with all of our master's and postgraduate courses, they are always designed based on the needs of the industry. And certainly computing technology, artificial intelligence, they are huge areas at the moment. I know it's something that the university is looking at expanding our postgraduate offering within that field. So at the moment, it's only cybersecurity, unfortunately. But that isn't to say that new masters will be announced soonish.
Thank you, Ryan. The next question is from Prashant Bukundoni. I have aviation history. I am a commercial pilot by profession. I do have a diploma in pilot training from Australia. I am looking forward to air transport with commercial pilot. Can I join this course?
Yeah, absolutely you can. Oh, cool. So you've flown in Australia as well. Wow, that's really worldwide. Yeah, so with our commercial piloting course, it is suitable for people who have piloting experience or for people who don't have piloting experience. So the most valuable part of that course for you would definitely be the degree aspect, because you already have some flying experience. But absolutely, you would be eligible for that course. And in fact, already having some flying experience would only strengthen your application. And there was a question about placements in there as well, was there, Ivana?
Yes, that's correct.
Yeah, so with placements, we do have really strong ties to the aviation industry because we're one of the few universities that offer piloting as a degree. We have a lot of different airlines and airport companies visit our university to speak with our students. And it's very common that they will walk into our classrooms with job applications. In terms of placements, because the course is structured so heavily around flying, there isn't a formal placement available, but that is a conversation you can have with the lecturers about finding a placement. It may be depending on how many hours your flight experience is, what level your pilot's license is, it may be that you can negate some of the flying and perhaps take on some form of placement in place of that. But actually, if you could email me, and I will have that conversation with the course leader for you.
Thank you, Ryan. And the next question is from Abhilash. Are there any suitable MBA courses for experienced professionals?
So it would depend entirely on, well, partially what your experience might be, but also what it is you would like to go into. In terms of the MBAs we offer, we have the typical MBA, but we also have the international MBA as well. And like I said, there is both a full-time on-campus version available, and there's also a purely online version available. So by all means as well, send me an email and we can see what the best option for you might be.
Thank you, Ryan. The next question is from Shajid. What is a typical IB score your university requires? Are there any subject-specific grade requirements?
Yeah, so with the IB is one I am asked the least about. I'm trying to remember it off the top of my head. But in terms of English requirements, if you've achieved above 65% in English in your year 12, we can accept that. We don't need any other English requirements. I know for IELTS, it is 6 overall. I'll need to double check the IB. I'm so sorry, I can't answer that one specifically. But in terms of specific courses that you have studied, if they are relevant to the course you're applying for, excellent. If they are not, do not worry. As long as you have the English, that is absolutely fine. And again, in your application, you just need to talk about why you want to study this course and why it might be suited to you.
Thank you, Ryan. The next question is from Nivek Varma. Hi, I'm looking for ODP courses at your university.
ODP, excellent. Operating Department Practice. Yes, so we actually have two options available. One is a diploma in Operating Department Practice, that is a 2-year course. The other one is the 3-year degree in Operating Department Practice. In terms of the course structures, they are very, very similar, but the degree offers you further career prospects in the future in terms of promotions once you've been working as an operating department practitioner. But again, like our aviation courses, it's a very niche area. So again, the employability prospects from that course are so, so high. So if you're interested in ODP, excellent decision, and hopefully I'll see you soon.
Thank you, Ryan. And the next question is from Shajid. What is the difference between TEF Gold and TEF Silver?
Oh, that is a very, very good question that I'm embarrassed to say I do not know the answer to. I will find out and get back to you.
Thank you, Ryan. That's a very honest answer.
Yeah, sorry.
The next question is from Ayesha Siddika. I have completed master's. I want to apply for my doctorate in business analytics. Is the course available at your university? And this another question from Ayesha. I'm married. I have kids. So is there any assistance for kids also?
Okay, yeah, so that is quite specific. I would ask actually that you email me about that, because I can speak with our compliance team specifically around your family requirements, and we can see what we can do for you there. Within the doctorate, we can see what options we have available for you as well. So I know you said it was within business analytics, but if you wouldn't mind sending me the full details, that's a conversation I can have with the business school and see what we've got for you.
Thank you, Ryan. I think, like, from what I see, we covered all the questions. So maybe we can just ask if anyone has any final questions. And if you would like to wrap up this session, please do so.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you all so much for listening. Those are all very good questions as well. I'm aware I said to all of you to email me. I do very much mean that. Please do get in touch, and I am happy to answer any and all of your questions. Remember as well that I was also a student of the university. So if there's anything you're also wondering alongside those other questions just about being a student at the university, by all means, ask me. There is no question I am not willing to answer. I'm more than happy to go through everything with you.
Thank you, Ryan. I would like to thank all students who attended today, and thank you for hosting this session with SA UK. It was great to have you.
Yes, and thank you very much for your help as well. It was great to be with you guys.
Lovely. I think that's it from questions, so we can slowly close this. Thank you very much again.